Flat earthers, as their name suggests, are people who believe that the world isn't spherical or isn't almost spherical, but rather flat. Now, I'm not here to mock those beliefs or show the fuzzy thinking behind those beliefs, not that I think it's necessarily wrong to do so, but I am here to ask, why do people believe in something that is so easily disproven? Out of all the conspiracy theories and pseudosciences out there, I think modern incarnations of theories surrounding a flat Earth are remarkable not because of their outlandish nature, but because the Earth's nature as a spherical body is so established as fact. Many Greeks stopped believing in a flat Earth 2,500 years ago. Pythagoras stated that the Earth was spherical in the 6th century BC. Aristotle provided evidence for a spherical Earth 330 years before Christ. Unlike the idea that the Earth revolves around the Sun, much of Europe in the Middle Ages believed in a spherical Earth. China was one of the last places to accept a spherical Earth, and they still started to do it 400 years ago. It's very easy to prove that the Earth is not flat. There's the Earth's curved shadow on the Moon, there's the curvature of the Earth, there's astrology, mathematics, and the fact people have gone in one direction for long enough, they finished where they started and didn't fall off. Jumbo, of course when I say that I'll go around the world in 80 days, I mean I'll walk around the rim. Anything else would be absurd. Modern beliefs surrounding a flat Earth started with Samuel Rowbotham, who published a pamphlet in 1849 called Zetetic Astronomy, which he later expanded into a book that seems to have originally been called Earth Not a Globe. Presumably he had to send his choice for the title via telegram and wanted to save on the letters. Interestingly, he wrote under the pseudonym Parallax, which I'm inclined to say is very modern of him. Did you know that George Rockall-Schmidt is actually a pseudonym? I don't know why I choose that as a pseudonym, but my real name is Parallelogram. Steve Parallelogram. And my archenemy is Alan Rhombus. Rowbotham was a great debater, and he made a lot of money charging for lectures, as well as from other ventures such as selling quack medicine. Flat Earth ideas prevailed in corners of the pseudoscientific community for years after Rowbotham, but it wasn't until 1956 that the Flat Earth Society was established by Samuel Shenton. With a few exceptions, what the society now believes is that the Earth is a disc. At the centre of the disc is the North Pole. Around the rim is a wall of ice. And from above, the disc looks like the flag of the United Nations. That same belief model also holds that the Moon and Sun are the same size, about 32 miles in diameter. Now, as with any belief, flat earthers don't agree on everything. Many don't believe in gravity as common science might understand it. They believe that the reason we don't float away from the Earth's surface is because the Earth, the disk that is the Earth, is being propelled upwards at about 32 feet, or about 10 metres, a second. So, why do people believe this stuff? There's no question a number of people who are part of the Flat Earth Society are part of it as a joke. There's no question some people who talk about it being reality are really being ironic. They're trolling, or maybe they're trying to make a point about critical thinking. However, I think out of all the people who publicly argue that the Earth is flat, only a small percentage are insincere. I think that the vast majority of flat earthers are sincere in their belief. I think a lot of that belief comes from ignorance. From people taking spirit levels on planes to monitor whether or not the pilot would dip the nose of the plane to compensate for curvature of the Earth, to arguments from people who just cannot believe that anyone can live in a spherical world Australia without holding on. Read any Flat Earther message board or comments on a Flat Earther video, and there are many rhetorical questions presented to pick holes in the idea that we live on a spherical Earth. However, these questions are usually very basic. I certainly don't think this is true of every Flat Earther, but I think for an enormous amount of Flat Earthers, their belief stems from ignorance. I think really their belief often comes down to their inability to really accept that the world is round, their inability to accept that it looks flat, but on a cosmic level, it really isn't. Issues of religious literalism also play a role. Beliefs surrounding the Earth being flat have often referred to various holy texts as proof, or at least as justification, for the belief. I think this is less of an issue now, but if your religious beliefs are so obviously contradicted by science, I think the strategic thing to do would be to reinterpret the text. But I think religious literalism is really only a motivation for a few flat earthers today. Modern flat earthers are usually conspiracy theorists. Unusually, they often don't believe in other conspiracy theories, but still, they do cite a global conspiracy to keep the real nature of the world from the public, usually orchestrated by NASA. Aside from the magical thinking, here's the problem. I can find no compelling reason to fake the world as a sphere. If the world was a disc, what would the benefit be of saying it was a sphere? And wouldn't hiding that fact make it very difficult in this modern age? Now, there are of course theories and no doubt answers to my questions. As with any conspiracy theory, there are explanations. And as with any conspiracy theory, it's attractive because it questions established authority and asserts the people in charge are in total control. It asserts that we are powerless. That is attractive to the disenfranchised, the marginalised, and the angry. Those who want to think that they are powerless, and conversely, those who want to think they're one of the few with secret and valuable knowledge. University of Kent psychologist Karen Douglas has said that a lot of the power behind flat earther beliefs lie in the fact that they are vague, and that they exercise minority influence. In this case, being somewhat effective because the claims are outlandish and therefore intriguing. Because flat earthers are often vocal about their beliefs, and because the core of the movement, if you want to call it that, are well rehearsed and can counter opposition. Look in the comments, there's probably someone who can counter everything I've said. There's probably someone who can prove that the world is flat. You've just got to follow their link. In fact, much of the pseudoscience and conspiracy theories surrounding a flat earth are highly convoluted and contain a lot of information. They kind of remind me of a Jorge Luis Borges story, Tlun Akbar Orbis Tertius, which mixes an imagined reality with our own. The conspiracy theories, the anecdotes, the apparent empirical evidence, and the very convoluted explanations can be quite compelling. But theories, science, basic facts don't come down to who argues better. I think really, a flat earth is attractive for people to believe in, mostly because of the same reasons other conspiracy theories are attractive. What makes this different is it's very easy to disprove, so you have people who double down and spend an awful lot of time nurturing what really is a fantasy. Other than that, I think Samuel Rowbotham exploited the idea for fame and wealth, and in the modern setting, I think some individuals have seen that by claiming that the Earth is flat, they can gain some notoriety. I think really, very few people believe this stuff. However, you can never underestimate the power of ignorance, or contrarianism. That's about all I've got to say about flat earthers and why they believe what they do. As ever, thank you very much for joining me. Don't forget to leave a like, and join me next time where I'll be talking about political correctness. See you then.